Hey, Matt's Garage here. So I'm going to be replacing the fan clutch on my 1990 Lincoln Town Car. It's got the 5-liter engine in it. And so if you've got a 90 or older town car with the 5-liter engine in it, this should apply to that. And so the first thing is going to be these 4 7/16 bolts. Make sure you get them broke loose before you loosen off your belt. And then once that's off, there's also these ones here. You can hold the fan blades and get them loose. I think they're 1/2 inch by the look of it. So we'll get all that off, and then we'll have to loosen off the fan belt as well, because this pulley's held on with these 4 bolts as well, so it will go all crooked if you don't take the belt off. And so we'll get to it here. I'm just going to loosen off the alternator. It's 9/16 here, or 14 millimeter. I guess 14 is probably the, this car is supposed to be metric. There we go, the belt is loose, and I've broken those all loose. I'm just using ratcheting wrenches down there, work best if you have them. And so the same thing I was having is the fan wasn't kicking out. It seized on, which you can tell that very easily by feeling it. It's completely seized solid, and also it was really loud on the highway, and you could feel it dragging on the engine. But they go both ways. Sometimes they don't grip enough on the clutch, and how you tell that is when you shut the engine down. If the blade keeps spinning, it shouldn't. It should stop really quickly when you shut the engine down. It should stop with the engine, basically. So that's how you tell if it's gone bad, if it's either locked up solid, or if when you shut the engine down it spins too long after the engine stops. So I'm just working on the last bolt here, and then should be able to pull the whole unit out. Try and do it so you can see it. Just be careful not to hit your radiator if you can avoid it. So you kind of got to rock that off there. It's got a bit of a snout that it fits over, whatever fits over the end of the shaft on the water pump anyway. There we go. And I'm not sure what the magic combination to getting it out here is. There we go, just like that. See there, the blades are spaced differently, so you can kind of spin it as you're taking it out. Makes it easier. So now you got to remove those 4 bolts there, and they're 1/2 inch or 13 millimeter, and I've already broken them loose when the belt was on. So, and then that blade lifts off, and then you install your, that's your actual clutch there. And I've actually just got a used one I'm going to be putting on today, because I've got a couple old ones kicking around. There's no point in wasting them, they still work fine. Being stubborn about pulling off of there, but there we go. It was just stuck on that lip there. And so I've got that oriented the same. Do that there. Uh-oh, there's a difference here. That hole is a different size. Okay, well, I've been foiled here. It looks like the 351 actually used a slightly different fan clutch. It's got a bigger mounting flange there. So I do have another 302 in the shop. It's only a year difference than this one, so it should have the right one. I'm going to go take it off and get back with you here. You can see the issue here. Unfortunately, I don't have the right part. I have a couple of other 302s here, And for some reason this Lincoln uses a bit smaller water pump flange. You can see this is the pulley off the Lincoln. That's the hole pattern I need. And you can see it's a little bit bigger. So I'm planning on turning those into slots, believe it or not. And the reason being is that this hole is what centers this. So as long as I can get this on here, it should remain in center anyways. Well, I've solved my problem. I've gone ahead, just taken my grinder, and I notched all those holes in, and I even ground around the outside. So if I put it on the center hole now, it's gonna be hard to see, but I think it's all lining up there. So we're gonna give it a trial fit here anyways. It's kind of dark out right now, so I'm just showing you this in the shop. You can see I have the fan blade on here again. This is the Lincoln one, and I actually went through a lot of work to get it on this Ford clutch because it doesn't fit. This was bigger and I had to grind it down, as well as notch out the holes, and I had to notch out these holes on the fan blade, but it's gonna work, so I say it was worth it. You got to make sure that the fan blade you're using is the right pitch. Like this one spins opposite as the this other used one I had, and that's why I couldn't just put it directly on, unfortunately. So just gonna fit this on here now, and I'll try and do it from the front here so that you can see. So just feed it down in there, kind of rotate it in. Careful not to stab your radiator. And then try and get the holes somewhat lined up as you push onto the water pump. There we go. Just a little stubborn getting started there. Now it is optional, you can put Loctite on these. They do have lock washers on them. I'm not going to worry about it. I've never had a problem with them coming loose before, but if you're worried about it, go ahead and put some on there. It won't hurt. The hard part is getting the first one started, and then after that you can just snug them all down and then tighten up your belt and then tighten them up good, and you're pretty much done. I find these ratcheting wrenches are really the thing to get in here good. So I've got it all installed, and I'm just gonna give it a quick test here and make sure everything sounds good and whatnot. Well, there we go. That looks like a successful repair. So thanks a lot for watching Matt's Garage. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more, and have yourself a great day.